Hey everyone, and welcome to a review of the HTC First. Now this phone costs $99.99 and will be available April the 12th. It ships exclusively on AT&T, and it's the first handset to come with Facebook Home already installed, as I already said. Now in case you didn't know, Facebook Home is a start screen replacement that draws you directly into the center of your Facebook world. However, when you look beyond Facebook Home, you'll find an exceedingly basic stock Android handset with none of HTC's characteristic attention to detail or well-crafted flair. Facebook and AT&T, and HTC for that matter, have traveled this road before, also with questionable results. While the First is no means as quirky or as limited as the HTC Status, in fact it offers quite competent mid-tier features like an HD screen, dual-core processor, and passable 5-megapixel camera, but its physical design also stops short of delivering a compelling reason as unique as Facebook's mobile aspirations. In other words, the HTC First, while affordable and completely serviceable, is really boring to behold, and HTC can do much better, namely the HTC One, the One X, and the One X Plus, the latter of which are on sale for the same or less under contract. Facebook Home, by the way, will also run on Samsung's Galaxy S4, Galaxy S3, and Galaxy Note 2, so there's really no need to buy the HTC First if you just want Facebook Home on your device. That said, if you're looking for an affordable stock Android experience, disabling Facebook Home gives you what you're after on the HTC First. And unlike the similarly priced LG Nexus 4, the HTC First delivers 4G LTE data speeds.